Hello everyone and welcome back to another episode of the Cube SMP server. Hopefully you are all doing well. Very good today. I'm doing good, thank you for asking. We are here at spawn, and guys, I want to go ahead and do something I've wanted to do for a while. So if we go down spawn road here and we look up at the sky, well, there's that behind you banner. And if you guys remember, I actually had Grape pay for that banner and put it up before PAX Prime. So this is like so overdue now, and I have to burn it down. And I've been waiting to burn it down, but the only way I can do it is if I disconnect that banner from the wooden thing, because I don't want the wooden thing to disappear as well. So when I burn it down, I can also start getting more people to get what they want written up there as well. So this should be fun. I want to do this in the most fun way possible. I'm just wondering if my boy Straub has restocked his ender pearls over here. No! There's no ender pearls. Dang it, man. That sucks. Okay, so I'm going to have to do with no ender pearls. That means I got to... I wonder if I have any myself. None. Absolutely zero. You know what? I missed the map that was here. It always got blown up. All right. Well, I guess I'm gonna have to do this old-fashioned way. So let's get some blocks ready and pillar up. I hate doing this, by the way. And my shovel's almost broken, so I should not use too much dirt if I was smart. I've got a few flint and steels with me prepared for this. Should be a fun time. Look at that slime down there. It's huge. I wish I could bow it right now. Doesn't that look cool? Like that cut off there with the path. We're gonna just disconnect this. I used a lot more dirt than I was hoping, but I looked at the shovel and it's got 28 durability left. I didn't even use close to 28 dirt, so should be no problem. Let's go ahead and disconnect this now. I've got shears for a reason, Graze. All right. I disconnected two rows just so I made sure it wouldn't spread. And now I'm gonna make my way up top. Oh man, here we go. Here we go. I'm just gonna use this flint and steel till it's gone. Oh, I'm starting to burn myself on fire. I just wanted to see the surrounding area. Make sure I'm not. Okay, so just about at the end here. And let's get off. Oh yeah, there she goes. And for the most part, it's gone, so I'll get rid of the rest off camera. But let's talk about some of the things I want to do this episode. Another thing I wanted to work on this episode was the head shop, or the head banner shop. I was told to change that name, so might as well just get rid of that. There we go. So a couple of episodes ago, you guys might remember that I started up the head banner shop, but I haven't done anything with it since. And I went ahead and tested it off camera, and yes, the only thing that can be made into a banner is the creeper head. And not the skeleton head. So I don't know what I'm gonna do with the skeleton head yet. I might put like a price on it or just keep it here for display. But the thing with the banners is that there are multiple backdrop colors that you can do with the banners, okay? So if I combine the creeper head with a black banner, then it's gonna be, I think, a black permanent creeper banner. You can't change that, as far as I'm aware. So what I think I'm gonna do, if that is the case, is I think I'm gonna combine the creeper head with a white banner, like the default one, and then as I get more heads in the future, I'm gonna expand it into more colors if it proves to be successful, so it should be a good time. Hey, and that Enderman just gave me the Ender Pearl I needed to get over to the castle to collect my funds for recording today's episode. Boom, boom. All right, guys, so let's talk crazy craft for a second here. It's like 90% of my comments these days is, when are you starting crazy craft? So I might as well go over it now. I've wanted to start it for a while, but it just won't work on my computer. So apparently other people on the server have had this issue, but nobody can help your boy Graze out because Graze is the only one that has a Mac. So what happens is, and I'll show you now, I go ahead and open the Void Launcher. So if you go and try to download CrazyCraft 3.0, you open the Void Launcher and it usually launches up all the things you need. But for me, it launches up like the icon on the dock, but it never opens anything. And so I can't do anything with regards to CrazyCraft. Like, I can't play it or anything. And so I'm asking you guys for help because I really would like to get started on this series. It's what a lot of the Cube members are doing these days. And I want to be a part of all that fun, but I just can't. And it's paining me. And the freaking problems that come with things sometimes. So if you have any solution to that problem, if you're some kind of really good developer or whatever, go ahead and leave a comment with your solution. If the solution looks good to anyone else, go ahead and thumbs it up. It'll make it easier for me to see the solution, and hopefully I can get started on that ASAP, because I know, and I see the comments, you guys all want me to get started on Crazy Craft, so shouldn't be too long now before I go ahead and proceed with that endeavor. But I think that's going to wrap it up for the intro for today. Let's get on with the episode. Russia, 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 Russia. You're always up to no good, man. Never are you up to any good these days.
What are you talking about?
You're just a troublemaker. On. That's all you're doing.
Stop touching me, man.
Like, jeez. I just don't know how you always manage to get yourself involved in certain situations. You know what I'm saying? It's just unbelievable.
Yo, get to the biz. I know you're trying to, you know, spice me up or something. What do you want? Come on,
well,
say it, buddy.
I mean, I just wanted to let them know that we're both in a rush. I mean, we both have food to get to soon, so I thought I would just prolong the clip a little bit, you know?
Yeah, just keep her going. My dinner place doesn't close in 15 minutes.
Alright, cool. So what's this over here, Rush, right here?
Oh, memories there. Hey, it's got some diamonds in it. I'll take it.
Yeah, take the diamonds, take whatever. Here's the situation at hand, because you want me to get right into the business, okay? So the other day, I come up to Will. I say, Will, I want to buy this shop from you because you haven't used it at all. And he says, okay, one problem though, Russia's shop is on my shop. We went into a deal. I own part of his, blah, 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 blah. So eventually we settled with 50-50. So I own the top floor of his shop. He owns the bottom. But we have to somehow get rid of your shop on the side because we can't have that anymore. So
you just want to get rid of it.
Yeah. Well, I mean, buy it out or something. We just can't have you involved in this business going on here anymore. So
this is my, you know, this is the shop that made me millions in the early days of Cube Season 2.
Okay.
This shop's simple. So, yeah, I'll be bought out. I mean, I'll take some cash. I'd love to go on a shop.
Now, I own, so as of now, you weren't there for the transaction. I own 50% of this building, okay? So what was Will's deal with you on this place?
Just out of curiosity. I got no clue.
Was it 50-50 or something like that? Because if it was, then now he owns 25% of it at the moment, if you're not bought
in. No, it was like, he got like 10.
10%. I own 5% of it then, if we're doing 50-50.
Holy God.
So if I don't buy it off of you now, then I currently own 5% and he owns 5%.
Okay? Of the steak shop.
Of the steak shop. Which I don't want to have to deal with if it ever gets sales or whatever. So I just want to like buy it out and completely own it and give like some of the profits to Will because he owns some of it. So is that cool with you? How much is your selling price for this thing?
Oh, it's you know, it's definitely more than a shack. So it's I'll take 1,000 diamonds.
Oh, 1,000 diamonds. I don't know if I can buy you
90.
90?
Fine, 69.
69? For 40. Two chests? Okay, when I'm buying this out, I guess I'm also buying out your farm at your house, too, to make the steak.
Oh, my God, dude. Right? You're going to go to my house,
How
dude?
Else am I going to produce the stuff?
That's true. It's a really good
farm. I guess I could, like, make one in the shop somewhere or something. That's like a side thing.
No, you can buy out my farm.
All right, seriously.
You can't touch my horse, though.
A reasonable price, though, because I don't think this thing's been filled up or had sales in months, so...
Well, I mean, I just pulled out 6 diamonds.
And?
Timesing that by 2 chests plus the farm, that's about 28 diamonds.
28 diamonds. All right, I'm cool with that. That's a reasonable amount.
You just negotiated me down from 1,000 to 28.
I know. How cool was that? Okay, Rusher, here you go. I'm going to quickly hand you over these 28.
Man, I'm so excited. What am I going to use this for?
I have no idea. You can go wild, but that's mine now.
I'm rich on here, man. I forgot about all
this. Actually, you know what? You want to bet on some stuff? Because I kind of need some money right now.
Yeah, sure.
Give me a diamond. Do you have a diamond?
Oh, I got a lot of them.
All right, here. I'll take a diamond. We're going to go up to Straub's head, okay?
I just dropped it and you walked away.
No, I got the diamond. How many gold blocks are you putting down on this?
A stack.
A stack of gold blocks. Okay, cool. There's going to be a diamond and there's going to be a piece of cobblestone in here, okay? They're randomly scattered. We're going to click it. If the diamond is dispensed, I get everything you put down. If the cobble's dispensed, you get everything I put down. Okay?
Deal.
All right, cool. So what are you putting down, you said?
Stack.
Stack. I'm only putting down like 20, man. That's all
do
I can 32. Afford.
32. I'll do half a stack.
All right, 32 each. Man. I'm broke if this goes wrong.
Come on.
All right, wait. What is it again? Diamond comes out, I win. Cobble comes
cobble
out, you win.
Cobble for me, diamond for you.
Okay. Click it.
Come on. Give me that cobble. Give me that cobble.
Click it, man. Click it.
Yes!
No! Yes! No! Are you serious, Russia? Please! Yes. No, I'm gonna go broke, man. You can't do this.
I knew that would happen. Hey, up, man. I'm gonna need it.
Yeah, because you need to go eat right now. So
exactly,
spend
man.
Your gold blocks at the restaurant.
This is such a good day. You just paid me 28 gold plus the 32. I almost got my 69 in the end anyway.
Oh my gosh, you suck. Why did that happen that way, man? That's not cool.
Dude, you gotta play the odds, dude. Cobble is, you know, more weight, more density than a diamond.
There you go, man, bro.
Thanks, man. I'm gonna use this for good stuff, man. I can't believe I won.
You suck! You suck! You suck!
Holy God, holy God.
You're gonna die! You're gonna pay for what you've done, Rusher! Rusher, you're gonna pay!
I'm shooting if I get to two hearts.
Okay, alright, I'm getting a call.
Take care.
Hold on. Yeah, what's up, man?
What the hell?
Fraser, I've been waiting for you.
I was actually just coming to check up on my building because I wanted to finish some of the slot machines in there, but if you have something
have
else...
Have you finished any?
No.
Alright.
Not yet. Let me come in. So what do you want? What are you here for?
I actually started trying to create games in here, Fraser. You want to come see
one? Ooh, okay. So, question. I just have a very big question. I don't know. I think I've asked you this before, but it was off clip and I didn't get a really solid answer. Oh! Okay! It makes sense now. So you have done more to the building. Before, when I saw the building, these staircases literally leaded into the wall, and I had no idea where they were going. Like, you said random staircase.
They were going into the wall.
I know, but, like, how are you supposed to go up that and then, like, take on the second floor? But I see how you did it.
You walk up and turn.
Yeah.
It's not hard.
But at first, like, without the floor, that's hard to visualize. Like, you can see where I'm coming at with that, right? Like,
not really. I think it's pretty obvious that you would turn.
Okay. All right. You finished it. It makes sense now. So this is what you're showing me is your top floor, your second.
Yes.
Is this going to be your top floor, or are you going to go even higher?
No, I'm going to go even higher.
Ooh. Okay.
Oh, I do have to make room for stairs. I didn't even think about that. Thank you for reminding me how much I suck. All right. So I created a roulette system here.
Okay.
You want to try playing.
I have no idea how roulette works at all.
So roulette's the game that, like, there's a little ball in there, and you spin it and you bet like red or black or whatever, or like red 22.
Okay.
And then if it lands on there, you get more money.
Okay. So yeah, I'm just gonna go off of that. I still don't know how to play it.
Well, pretty much on this thing, you want to land on this, the little tracks with the red stuff that comes off it.
All right,
so if you land on like the red over here or the red over here, it will normally turn this on, so it's literally like a 50-50 chance.
Okay,
so now what you're gonna do is you are going to place a gold block in here.
Oh, you're lucky I came with one. Only one on hand, though.
And now you're going to walk across these pressure plates and see how much coal you get.
Literally just walk across them.
Yep.
And one, them can up. I stay on it as long as I want, or do I just walk across?
I mean, sure. You're just going to get hit by one like piece of coal or one cobblestone. You could either get coal or cobblestone. So I'm going to stand in the middle here. And now you go around here. And you have to use all three of those coals and power the furnace and see if you land on or light up the redstone when it stops.
Okay,
you ready
so
to go?
Do I do it now? Here we go.
Yep.
Ready? Three. Do I right-click all the coals at once or, like, as it goes?
It's up to you.
Okay, Now, I don't know how minecart furnaces work. I don't know if it, like... Okay, I'm just going to do it all at once. All at once. Oh. Okay. So what happens now?
I don't think you won anything, Grayson.
No, so let's see. Let's say it would have landed on this. What would I have won?
You would have clicked on this button above and see what you have won.
So question, what happens if you get cobble? Like, that doesn't help towards the powering of the furnace at all? So
That's just, like, the chance. Like, you can get one to three. One of these has full cobble or coal in it, so you
Frigger!
Only get this one.
I only got one coal out of that one and two cobble. Here we go, ready?
I mean, it's complete chance. It doesn't really matter what you get.
Let me put a gold block in here. Yeah, but it just does. It means like it won't power as long, I guess. Here we go. Come on. Yes.
Ooh.
Yes. I won something. That's a win, right?
Yep, that's a win.
All right. So as long as the thing is lit up, it's a win or no?
Yep.
Okay. Here we go. What do I win? What?
You get three.
Yeah, I got three. I want to do this again.
Really?
This is fun. This is fun. Okay.
See, the same thing as with these dispensers up here. The middle one, you will always get a gold block. And then the other two, you have a 50-50 chance of getting a gold block or cobblestone.
Oh, okay. So question about... Oh, I just fell off the freaking building. Question about the whole furnace thing. If I power it once and then it stops and it doesn't win, can I power it again?
Yeah, you have to use all the coal you get.
Oh, so I can... I don't... All right.
So like, if you use one and it stops and you win, you still have to use the coal.
Oh, no. Okay, so that one didn't win, so I got to use it again. Here we go. All right,
but
that's the last
three?
Coal. I had only had two. And I win again.
Wait.
No.
Go.
That's a win. No.
Yeah, that's a win.
Let's see. Come on. Give me three. Oh, yeah. I got I think
I got the cobblestone.
Okay, well, I got two there. Okay, one more game. This is so fun. Oh my gosh, what did you think of this game? I guess it's a real game.
Yeah.
All right, here we go. Ready? So what's the deal with you standing in the middle? What does that add to it?
I just want to be in the middle.
Oh, okay. Here we go.
If you would have gotten... Oh, you have one more piece of coal?
Yeah, I got one more. Oh, that would have been a win, too. Okay, one more. Come on. No, it's a lot. Yes. Come on, keep going.
No, keep going.
Keep going. No. Okay, yeah. You know what, H? I think this could be a really fun game. I'm having a good time with it. But what about Russian roulette? That could be a pretty cool time as well, right?
Do you want to go that intense?
Yeah, like the one where it lands and you die or live.
All right, well, let's try that out. We'll go. I'll go first. I'll put in a goal block.
Okay.
I'll walk across.
Okay, so yeah, you walk across.
Cobble, coal, and coal. All
right.
Okay, so I'll go first. Now, if I lose this, I guess you kill me.
Okay. Perfect.
Kind of scared for my stuff right now. Don't pick
I
any
wish
of
there
up,
was an
please.
Actual way to play Russian roulette, like a gun was on the Minecraft. You can load it with like bullets, and then one bullet, one
it's
slot.
It's a kid game, Grizzly.
No, you didn't win. Oh no, you had another coal. You had another coal. I was just ready to kill you right there. Yes?
Oh, whoops.
Yeah, that's not a win.
God dang it, alright, kill me. Don't pick up any of my stuff.
Alright, strip your clothing, bro.
That's weird. Just kill me quick.
Goodbye. See ya, H. Alright, so here we go. I'm gonna put my goal block in now. I believe I already did when you were doing the leap of faith. So I'm gonna go ahead and walk across the coals. Got
how
two
much coal?
Coals. Two Ooh. Coals. Here we go.
I think you're going to lose because of that.
So it's the way you power it. If I power it from this end, it's going to go this way. If I do it from this end, it's going to go that way, right?
I think so. I've never really messed with
watch.
Much.
Look. This way goes this way. Pretty sure.
Oh, like you should like when it's like halfway, like still going, you should switch it up and go to the other side.
That's what I'm saying. And then this way, we'll go that way. Oh, come on. I don't want to die. I really, really don't want to die.
God dang it.
Yes, man. So what do I do? Can I click the button?
If you paid for it, sure.
I did pay for it.
Oh, yeah!
That wasn't too good. So I'm guaranteed to get my goal block back every time then.
If I win.
Okay, yeah. Cool.
If you lose, then I'm going again. Hold on.
Oh, you're going to go again? Is this still Russian roulette or just normal roulette?
This is just normal roulette. I want to win.
All right, I might go too. But this is all your goal blocks that you're just giving back to yourself.
Are you ready for this? I'm going
to
switch it up.
Two, three. Okay,
halfway through.
Two.
Oh, I juked it.
Oh, he switches it up. This is a fun game, H.
Like come on, go!
I'm severely
I hate this game.
I'm severely enjoying this game. I really want to kill you.
Severely?
That's okay. Here we go.
Wait,
it
you're
up.
Severely enjoying this game?
Okay, switch it up. What do you mean?
Severely means like you got like hurt like really badly.
No, I lost.
Yes.
All
I
right.
Still think
well,
you ended up like coming out above.
No, I definitely did, and I have my life spared, so I'm good to end the clip here, Mr. HBone94.
Yeah.
No! You always do this.
What? What were you trying to do? You said I got you. Like,
I'm hiding from you, Naboom.
Hey, Grazer, is that you?
I'm hiding from you.
Oh, maybe he's behind this pillar.
No,
he's not behind that one.
No,
maybe he's under the staircase.
No, not
there either.
No.
I wonder if he's under the block here.
No,
not under there. Oh. Wait, where the what?
I am here because I'm here to help you, Noboom. You told me today you really required help, and I'm here to help. So what do you mean?
So I spent like the last hour, right, just going through the Nether, searching under every boulder I could find.
Boulder? And, okay, interesting.
Well, you know, a little creativity's needed in stories. So
just like this crafting table on this tree, right?
yeah, what the heck? Why is that? Okay. Anyways, so yeah, I was going through the Nether and I couldn't find any blaze rods. No blaze spawners. The Nether fortresses were abandoned. So I was looking to you. I'm thinking, you know what? I bet Grazer's got. I bet he's stacked. I bet he's stocked.
Well,
up
I
on
do
those.
Have blaze rods. Now, why did what? Like, what took you off of the interest of just wanting rods? Why do they need to be blazed rods? Like, what's the difference?
That's. I don't really know how to respond to that. But,
You want blaze rods, right? I've got two of your blaze rods. I'm pretty sure I have you some blaze rods, okay? So I didn't.
Okay.
I think they're. I think they're down here. I stored them.
I had
them.
A hunch.
You kind of passed the building, but all right.
Oh. No, I was just looking around.
I think they're down here in my vault in Grape's place. So if I go over here and I open up my storage.
Okay, very cool.
I think I have some. Oh, yeah, I do. Oh, I have. Oh, okay. Yeah, I have quite a few blaze rods in there. So,
oh,
Mr.
No
Boom. What were you planning on paying for your blaze rods today? Because I'll give you my price after you tell me what you thought you were going to pay so I can have a good laugh.
Oh, all right. Well, first of all, so I'm looking to have, I think, about 16 blaze rods.
16 blaze rods, okay. Yeah, I do have that quantity for you.
Then I'm looking to pay, I'm thinking... Because they're hard to find right now. I don't know really what's in stock.
Yeah, fortresses are far. I mean, I got these right at the beginning of the season, so.
All right. Well, in that case, I'm willing to pay 5 gold blocks for 16.
For 16. Okay, here's the deal, all right?
Yep.
I'll charge you 10 gold blocks for 16, but if you get 32, I'll charge you 15. Ooh, so you get some money off if you go for the 32 option. Ooh, no boom's thinking now.
I don't know. Hold on. I offered 5.
You offered 5.
And then you said you'd give me 16 for 10, so you straight up doubled mine.
Yes, that would be
without
my
even,
price.
You know, you're just like, yeah, okay, I'll give you what you offered, but double your price.
Yeah, but if you go for 32, I'll only give it, like, for 15 when it's worth 20.
Why'd you just hit me? What was that for?
I don't know.
Are you trying to, like, slice me into the deal? You know, I'm thinking here,
He's negotiating, guys.
How about we do, yes, that is what I'm doing. How about we do 12 gold blocks.
12 gold blocks.
For 30.
For 30. All right. I think that's a deal. I kind of like that.
All right, cool. Well, for one thing, I need to grab more gold blocks.
Oh, okay. Wait, how many do you have on you? Hey, I got you an achievement, too. That should be worth something, right?
Woo! Oh, sweet. Yeah, there you go.
Awesome.
I'll give you a flint and steel for giving me that achievement, too.
Thank
you. As a present. I have 10 on me, and I'll go back to my house and grab 2 more.
2,000 years later.
All right, now, Boom, I hear that you've got my gold blocks. Give me the extra 2.
I have your 2 gold blocks, Grazer.
Thank
this one.
You. Oh.
And there's another one. Wait. And drumroll. Do a drumroll.
Woo! Yay! There you go. Thank you. All right. Thank you so much, Noboom, for the gold blocks. It was a pleasure having you. Goodbye. All right. So you guys remember this, the whole chest sponge ordeal at spawn. I'm actually going to go ahead and take most of the sponge and just surround the book because I want the whole like puzzle thing to stand. So with a real gold blocks, please stand up, have the sponge there as fake gold blocks. But you guys remember a lot of episodes ago, maybe 5 or 6, I went ahead and blew up the whole sponge shop or the cheese shop. And I did that because it wasn't making any business. So today, I want to redefine how I'm going to go about doing the entirety of the sponge shop. And I thought, why not take that deal that I made with Will and take advantage of it that way? So at the moment, I actually kind of do owe Will some gold blocks just because I bought out the whole steak shop. I think I can pretty much just tear this down now. I won't tear it down. Maybe keep it there just for some legacy purposes. But we don't have Rusher involved with the whole business anymore. If we go in, I've redesigned this to look like a crummy old sponge shop over here. And then over here is where you toss your payment over the counter. So this is where the new sponge shop is going to be. And you might be asking, well, how do I get to the payments? You go down here to get to the payments. Thank you for asking. I need to go ahead and fix all of this up, though. That's kind of an issue. So the payments are going to be there. That's where they're going to filter through. And then the sponges are going to be in this chest here. Now, the prices are going to be very cheap. Probably going to sell them for like 1 gold block of sponge or 2 gold blocks of sponge or something like that. Which makes me think that I'm probably put things that are more valuable in the chest at the royal thing. You guys are probably wondering where the heck a Will's part of the shop is. And it's going to be more evident in the future. But right now, you just open this up. And it drops you right down into his compartment where you can click this and it'll open you up into whatever he's got planned over here, which is his tile thing. Another thing I'd like to show you is the updated Nether Hub that was started last episode, and it looks like some progress has been made. Not much, but still enough to warrant the showcase, so check it out. Now a whole like boundary has been set for the largeness that it's going to be, and some floor patterns, I guess, have been tested out on what designs are going to go ahead and make the... make the cut. I'm not a builder, so I don't know how this process works, but should be pretty cool. That's the nether hub as it stands. And finally, let's go ahead and make the move. The move that everybody's been waiting for. We're gonna combine this creeper head. Okay, I thought it went up, like over the wall into the ground or whatever. And we're gonna combine it with this banner, and that's what it's gonna make us, and it's done! So now I just have to duplicate a lot of these, and people can design it how they would like. I'm gonna go ahead and put this into a secret chest, probably underground, just so that nobody touches it, because I'm not ready to open the shop just yet. But yeah, I think that's gonna wrap it up for today's episode, everybody. So if you did enjoy, be sure to leave a rating, and I will see you guys all again next time. Goodbye. Oh, forgot to put that down. Oh, and collect that. Goodbye.